I'm not sure many of you realize how what a big deal it is that you have not just two, but three of the biggest environmental NGOs actually working together. We are collaborating, we're sharing donor lists, we're sharing donors, we're talking every day. It's actually really transformational for our sector because I mean, I'm sure as Carter can appreciate, our organizations often compete. And so the fact that we've said, look, we don't have time for that competition. We have got to sit down together as a community and work together. It's really game changing. So I just want to make that point and thank Carter for an incredible partnership. So in terms of TNC and our financial transactions, so we want to solve, help countries solve two big problems. One is in the case, as Prime Minister Briseño was mentioning, their debt crisis. And obviously with COVID, especially a country that's so reliant on tourism, like Belize or like Costa Rica and many others, I was just in Kenya, saw exactly the same thing, where we as conservationists have thought for so long, well, ecotourism is the best. It's amazing. You're preserving nature. You get people to come and be educated about nature. It's great until you have a global pandemic. And then it's not a great choice for your economic model if that's all you have. So what we're seeing and trying to help in Belize and other countries is a model where we can, as Prime Minister Briseño said, take some of that debt burden and transition it into a conservation win. And so we've been working very hard with many partners for the last 2 years, 18 months or so. And there will be a very big announcement on Friday about this, but just to say, this is the second of what we're calling the Blue Bonds transactions. The first was 5 years ago in the Seychelles, where the Nature Conservancy and partners work very closely with the government of the Seychelles to create a marine protected area that is twice the size of the UK. Huge area, 30% of that country's exclusive economic zone, and in exchange, they were able to reduce their debt burden. Really great outcome. We're looking to do this in many other places. And as you can imagine, given the highly indebted nature of so many countries right now, especially that we're reliant on tourism and that have an amazing biodiversity and have committed through the High Ambition Coalition to a 30 by 30 agenda, they're looking around and saying, we want to do this, but how do we pay for it? So our job in the donor community and the NGO community is to be there to provide the support that we can for them to achieve their goals, because it is amazing. All of these proclamations that were made today, the billions of dollars, but at the end of the day, if his government doesn't have the budget or her government doesn't have the budget or the communities on the ground don't have the incentives and the money that they need to conserve, it's all platitudes. So that is our goal, is to really make sure that you all have the resources that you need. So whether it's a debt swap and a PFP, which in many countries we're seeing the need for both, because one transaction alone will not fully fund the conservation that's needed forever, as Gustavo rightly said. So how do we bring all these incredible opportunities together and help and support governments and the 30 by 30 ambitions? So that's some of what we're doing.